Hardly.
That was nice.
Welcome back to the studio.
Supercharge.
Yes, supercharge.
Duh.
Sorry. We got the beautiful and lovely Sarah Dawn Finer here.
Sarah.
Give people applause.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Always.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I just said that. It's so weird because she's one of my best mates.
Yeah.
And now I'm on the other side.
And you're going to interview me in English.
English.
No less.
Well, we said that Andreas won't interview you. Yeah. He'll just talk.
Yes.
Yeah. And
yes,
I'll do the interview.
Exactly.
So
yes.
I'll do it's like, how are you feeling?
Yes.
And he'll say, wow, that's
great.
So stupid.
Yes.
Progressive.
Yeah.
All right. So how are you feeling?
I'm very warm. It's a beautiful day here. It sort of feels like we're in Cannes or in south of France somewhere. It's really eclectic. And it's so funny because I was walking around the streets trying to get to a place where I didn't really know where I was going. And every person I asked wasn't Swedish. So you really notice how many people here are here just for the Eurovision.
Yeah. So you were going around to a place that you don't know.
No,
that's
ask
hard asking for direction.
Yeah.
Well, do you know a place where I don't know?
Eventually, I had a map, so that was
okay. Yeah. Great.
So why are you here?
Well, for a bunch of different reasons. I did a thing yesterday, sort of like as opposed to a roast, I was toasted. So there was a celebration, actually in my honor, quite oddly, at a theater around the corner.
Josefin Jonsson, right?
Christopher Jonsson.
Yes. And yeah, there's no Josefin.
No, she
wasn't there.
No.
Ah, okay.
I just got people made my favorite food, and artists, local artists, sang my favorite songs, and people said nice things about me. So that was lovely.
Oh wow!
And then I'm here doing a bunch of different things. I'm going on Gina's show tonight for this SVT Studio Eurovision. And
Trader.
Maybe sort of yeah, exactly. And sort of celebrating the Eurovision. Life of, in this case, mainly Linda Woodruff, which is...
Exactly. Linda Woodruff, everybody who loves Eurovision, all the Eurovision fans, they know Linda Woodruff.
They know me mainly now as some kind of old English comedy character.
Right, because you have this alter ego. Some artists like Beyoncé, she has Sasha Fierce, and then you have Sarah Dawn Finer, and she got Linda Woodruff. How did that character come about?
The actual Linda Woodruff character was brainstormed with Edvard af Sillén and I, who's the director for the Swedish Melody Festival, when I was hosting that 1.5 years ago. But the original voice came from a voiceover show that I did about 2008, that the EBU was organizing a program to send out to all the competing countries, and they asked for a voiceover. And I do a lot of voiceover work, so they sort of just picked me out of a number. They didn't know that it was me and that I actually was a singer and blah, blah, blah. So I came to the studio and they said, oh, we're doing this show for the Eurovision and it's a program about all the competing countries and we want you to do it in British English. And my mother's from America and my father's from England, but this is usually the way I speak English. Mm-hmm. So the only British English that I sort of had in my head was this voice of a narrator who does a show, at least back in 2007, called Ibiza Uncovered. And I don't sleep much at night, so I was up usually during the night.
Do you know that show?
No, I don't know.
And it's a travel show with British people going to strange places. And she has this wonderful way of speaking. And she's sort of nonchalant at the same time as being quite funny. So she would say things like, Jenny and Andy are going to the nudist beach today. They don't know what's going to happen. And so I was telling these people about this show and I was doing the voice and they say, oh, you have to do it that way. So I did the entire Eurovision program saying things like, this year we have a singer from Slovenia. And they thought it was really funny. So cut to 4 years later, I'm sitting with Edward and we're talking about skits to do when we're hosting the Melody Festival, and I said, I'm really not that funny in Swedish, I don't think, but I have this one voice. I think that's sort of funny. I do it at parties. And I did it, and he cracked up, and we started talking about who she could be, and I was like, maybe she'll be like a Eurovision fan, and he said, she could work at the EBU. And then he found this picture of this sort of congresswoman lady, and so we built the whole visual, you know, the wig and all that stuff on this woman, and then we just started brainstorming the whole thing about her not trying, you know, she can't really pronounce words, and her, she's very enthusiastic, but she's sort of nasty. And then, after like an hour of taping that original skit, which aired in the final 2 years ago, we noticed that because it was in English, a lot of the Eurovision fans could see it on YouTube. And therefore, I was asked to give out the points in the actual Eurovision, which was sort of a stretch since people don't know that she's not real. And then I got to do it again this year. And then here we are in front of 100 million people seeing this woman going, are they actually sending an official EBU woman? Or, so there's a lot of tweets going out on Twitter saying, no, she's not real. She's actually a Swedish singer.
But that's the fun thing, though, when you notice you have a hit, when people start, you know, is this true or isn't it true and blah, blah, blah. But are you, since it's just taking off, you can't, after the programs, if, you know, when I check my social media, it's just going crazy about Linda Woodruff. Are you, because you're, I mean, we were talking about this, and you didn't agree, but I said you had the best, greatest Swedish voice. I'm just kidding.
I was the one to say that. The best female voice in Sweden. Current.
Yeah, and it's true. I mean, you're an awesome singer. And
thank
I mean,
you.
You've been, you're doing a performance in the United States and in Sweden, mainly.
Mainly Sweden. Yes.
But are you sort of afraid? But, that when Linda would like take off,
take
it.
Your,
it's like wait, I'm a singer too.
Isn't
I'm a singer
good,
too.
Well, isn't that fun?
Well, I mean, I think everything good sort of leads to other good things, and who knew I was funny? Yeah. I mean, I didn't.
Well, I did.
Well, I mean, I didn't know I was funny that way. So that's sort of like, I don't know. I think it's an added bonus to life. I've noticed because of a lot of things I got to do last year. With the character and then hosting television shows, that when I just finished my tour now, as a performing artist, I'm a lot more confident in talking and being funny on stage as my private artist self because of the experience I'm starting to get, sort of just, I guess, letting loose. I'm not afraid that it's going to take me... I mean, if she'll become a female Borat of the world, I'll be thrilled.
Yeah.
That's
a good idea,
side.
Though. I would totally it watch is, that movie.
I would totally
watch that movie. You go traveling program.
Let's get some sponsors. Yeah. Awesome. Telia?
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
You're on it. Good.
And he's just staring
up. No, but I mean, people have approached me to do a lot of projects with her, and we'll see if anything pans out. I'm just happy, sort of. I think ultimately. You know, one thing leads to another, and if people find my music through this skit, then fine. If they don't, and just someone in the Ukraine is laughing because I'm funny, then that's insane.
Yeah.
And it just sort of makes my day. Of course, I've noticed that she's very popular, and of course in England and in Australia and every English-speaking country, because even the English-speaking is, I mean, she's not very good at English all the time. So I think for a lot of the other countries, they need her subtitled to sort of understand the jokes.
Okay.
But it's just, she looks funny and she can't really sing. Tonight, the skit that's on tonight is from Malmö, when she's traveling to Malmö, and how she's falling in love with Slayton. as she calls him.
That's awesome. For you guys who haven't seen it, we actually have a little skit that we're allowed to watch. So why don't we take a look at Linda Woodruff?
Hello, everyone. This is Linda Woodruff, and I have a message from the European Broadcasting Union, the EBU. I would like to welcome you all to the home of the Eurovision Song Contest 2013, the amazing Friends Arena in Stockholm.
No, it's in Malmö.
What?
Malmö.
In Malmö. It's in Denmark.
No, Malmö, Sweden.
Hello, everyone. This is Linda Woodruff welcoming you all to the home of the Eurovision Song Contest 2013, the slightly smaller Malmö Arena. Well, it's cozy. Crash, boom, bang. Last year in Azerbaijan, in Baku, Sweden won with the amazing song Euphoria by Lorraine Lolo. And brought the contest back to Malmö. The city of Malmö has so much to offer, both when it comes to culture and food, like this speciality, the spit cake. It's spit and sugar in a cake. Smells delicious. Also, the south of Sweden has brought the world so many talents. The amazing Anita Ekberg, Slayton, and of course, the Pepsi person. So, to all you Eurovision fans out there, welcome to Malmö, where myself and the amazing Laloy Taloy will see you in May. Goodbye! Bloody hell, let's go to Copenhagen for a pint of beer.
Amazing.
The funniest thing, though, for me, is that there are actually still Swedish people who don't know or believe that it's me.
Really?
Yes.
Where we had
we had the rap party for the big Melody Festival, the final this year, and the guy who actually arranged that party, who was the like head chief of that thing, had said to one of the producers for the show, "Oh, it's so funny you found that English lady and brought her back on the show." Oh. And they go, no, that's Sarah Dawn Finer. And they go, no, the English lady, that was the one that was going to... And they go, it's Sarah Dawn Finer. No, you couldn't get me on
See,
that.
So
I love that still is happening, that people sort of don't... I mean, the people outside of Sweden, I get, of course, who they don't know who I am. But here, I thought that
That's
people
crazy.
Knew that by now.
That's fun, though.
Yes, it's wonderful.
Do you ever get like a
laid? No.
That was actually.
Do you ever get
it wasn't. That wasn't this question I was going to go, but it was leading up to that one. Actually,
a lot of dates.
Do you go out?
No, I don't.
As her?
No.
I guess.
I don't think that would work in my favor.
What would Linda drink if she went out?
Oh, she goes for pint beer.
Pint beer. Really?
Yeah, definitely. Oh, really? She's very British. That way.
But tell us about her. I mean, who is she? And then we're going to talk about you. This is what I'm talking about. I want to know about Linda, really, and you.
Who made up?
I don't know.
First of all, who made up the name? Who came up with the name?
Well, Linda was the narrator of this Eurovision show, Ibiza show.
Oh, okay.
And so Linda.
Linda with a Y, right?
Yes. Mm. I think Edward made her up with a Y, but. And then he made up the name because it sounded just really insane, the last name. She works at the EBU, which is sort of funny because when I met the head of the EBU, Jan-Ola Sand, who's the boss of the entire Eurovision Broadcasting Union, he whispered to me, "There are a lot of ladies who work with us who are very much like us." So we were sort of spot on. But I mean, she's sort of, Edward tells me all the time, she sort of has gotten this this job to go around and represent them and send these movies out to the competing countries. She's like no budget. In the Eurovision, she has a little more budget. We actually get to travel like to Jukkasjärvi. But I mean, she has no budget and she's sort of angry all the time, except for in front of a camera. But the rest of her life, I'll save for the Linda Woodruff, the true story.
Oh, yeah,
the
true story. Yeah.
That's
but
awesome.
But I mean, if you look at like some of the British characters, because now I've started to look to watch a lot of British comedy, and there are similarities with that kind of comedy with... If you look at things like Catherine Tate and Little Britain, yeah, and all that stuff, so now I'm like stealing small pronunciations. Even actually, I don't know if you ever saw this. This is sort of a YouTube phenomenon. There were two English girls that went to the Ellen Show in America, yeah, called Sophia Grace and Rosie.
No.
They're very small, and they say, "Oh my God, it's amazing," all the time.
So you stole some of that.
So I've been sort of listening around to anything British to see what works, and then Edward's laugh when we record the sketches are sort of my go-to sign that it's funny.
That is funny,
because
yeah.
I don't know humor that well yet, so I don't really know when the timing is funny. I just sort of try.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But But you have like a timing naturally, because it has to be, because when as I said, we don't know each other.
You're
that
comedian,
well, but
yeah, so you know.
Yeah, but and we've been out, and you're delivering.
Yeah, she's quick.
With
she's
comedians quick. Also,
she
you're
delivers.
Going bomb, yeah.
So yeah, you're,
so so you have that naturally. But is it? I mean, since you're a great singer again. You're like awesome.
She sang in my 40th birthday. See.
Yeah.
Just say that.
I had nobody. I had
cried.
A little speech.
Cried. We all cried.
I cried. You cried. We all cried.
Which song did you sing?
One of my songs that a Swedish song.
I don't know. It's just one of my songs.
That's personal.
It's very personal.
Is it?
Yeah. Okay.
The song to your.
It's yeah. Moving on.
Okay, moving on.
Yes.
Okay. Moving on.
Was it that one? No, it's good. I'm just kidding. Yeah. I mean,
40th birthday party. You're moving on.
That would have been fun.
I'm like, yeah, I know. Yeah.
Yes,
but
yes,
rub it in.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway, so, but.
Oh, funny story.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
That,
thank you.
Yes. we've known each other for almost about 10 years mm-hmm. or so, but I think the first time we actually. Started talking professionally was because I recorded a demo for a song called Not a Sinner Nor a Saint that got a place in the Swedish Melody Festival that Alcazar did. Mm-hmm. So the first time I think we spoke...
I think it was around then.
And you said, we heard the demo of the song and we love
it.
So I sang it originally. Yeah. So there's a version somewhere out there.
It's a bit more soul-y though, like...
I don't know. It was trying some kind of Anastasia phase.
And then
I was about 21.
Made it like this.
They made it disco.
No.
Yeah. Their version is so much better though.
Is it? I mean...
Yes.
But I think you're performing that song tonight, aren't you?
No.
I'm performing at Euroclub, yes.
At Euroclub.
Yeah,
and you were talking about that song.
Quick guest appearance.
Yeah. And you were talking about that song.
No, I didn't talk about that song.
Yes, you did.
I'm doing Stay the Night.
Oh yeah, it was Stay the Night. I'm sorry.
Alcazar, a lot of hits,
a lot
of
too many hits. Yeah.